Everybody, how's it going? Ron Watson, Positive Vibe, host of Disc Dogger Weekly. Gonna work on throwing shapes this morning. We've hit on interception versus chase. I'm gonna work on delivering throws so that you can make shapes happen initially. Shapes aren't just the triangle that we use to equate interception versus chase. Shapes are also how our dog moves around the field. And we can affect that with throwing, and we can affect that with handler movement. Right now we're gonna discuss throwing. Do you wanna do it, Epi? Let's do it. Come on. Awesome. First thing we need to do to create some shapes is to throw laterally. That's gonna bring the dog coming in at an angle that's interesting to us. So if we throw, oust, catch, if we throw that way, the only way the dog's gonna return to us is in a linear fashion there. Really limits the amount of angle that we can employ with the dog. You ready, Epi? Makai, get out. Throwing it like 10 o'clock. It's gonna set up a nice arcing retrieve. Ep, can't reach it. Makai, catch. Another thing that'll work to keep the dog on flank is to use the confines of the field. So simply by changing to this orientation and throwing, making sure that I throw it a little bit to the inside of his line, oust, I can keep him moving on that flank. So the field can control which direction our dog turns. Makai, catch. He'll catch this and he'll peel off counter. You can see that we're going towards the edge of the field going this way. He's going to peel off counter. If I bring him, Makai, coming in a little bit, he won't peel off counter that way. He's gonna continue on clock because the field is pushing him in. Oust. Again, if I send him around here and throw out there, he's gonna release counter. Those trees are in the way, the edge of the field is giving pressure. Oust. Makai, catch. This one here, he's gonna continue on clock because the field is pressuring him in. Where we throw in relationship to the edges of the field has great bearing on the shapes that we have coming on. All right, so Heiser and Anheuser also have a lot of bearing on what direction the dog is gonna release to. Makai, catch. If I throw it with a lot of Heiser, he's likely to turn off counter clock. Oust. If I throw it with Annie, he's gonna be likely to continue on that flank going in that direction. Oust. Makai. If it Heiser's out, you probably go counter. Oust. Makai. And he's going clock. Good job, Epi. Heiser, Anheuser has impact on your shapes. So we can throw on flank or we can set the flank. When we set the flank, oust. We're driving the dog out there. Get out there, right? Get out there, handsome. You can see it's gonna be a real linear line coming back at me. Oust, Makai, get out. If I set the flank or if I throw on flank, he's likely to hold that line. Oust, Makai. Right, nice arcing thing. If I rip him out there, oust, Makai, and I get him going fast and I drive him out, he's gonna have no choice but to come at me in linear fashion. Even if he were to turn the other way, it would be this nice, this real long linear approach. Epi, that was great work.